I'm now going to attempt a striper topwater fly. I've caught black bass with it. Again, I'm going to use a Daiichi 2546 2-aught. Tying thread, I'm going to use the Gutabrau GX2, good strong thread in it. Lasts if you rinse your saltwater flies off after you use them. If you have a place where there's big black bass, this works good too. It's an old style of tying. I use this slinky blend material. You can use any fish hair type stuff. I like the profile this makes. And I tied a good thread base down. And I'm gonna take about 50% of this hair and lay it on the top of the hook shank and take right in between a barb and a hook. And I'm gonna tie in about 3/16 of a thread wrap. And I'm gonna bring my thread right to the center of that thread wrap. And I'm gonna flip that material over and capture it. Then I'm gonna try to make another 3/16 of an inch. Go over it once or twice and tie that off so I keep the tension on the thread. Use a little bit of head cement. Do another. This color is off white. Most of your bait fish are light on the bottom. I'm gonna tie that in right where that hump is, about 3/16. Go to the center of that thread wrap. Seems like all my flies are pretty repetitious. And this is definitely not anything that I invented. I think Joe Brooks tied this in the 50s, this type of fly. Gotta keep it on the top. Come back to the middle. That off. A little head cement on this one. See how them segments are being tied in there. Maybe one more of these. Get ready. I think I have a color change right now. Tie that off. Now I'll put a little brown, and this has got a little sparkle in it. Tannish, be a sardinia or a mullet, or even a shad. See that profile, it's starting to come out. Well, it's nice. Okay. Put one more. I try to keep about the same amount on each wrap. It's pretty hard. Just got a little ratty. Okay, that's about right. Just about where the wraps on there, just about halfway between the point and the eye. I'm gonna tie that off. Now I'm gonna switch over and put my deer hair. First segment, I'm going to leave the tips, get all the under fur out of there. Try to get about 50% of the hair and roll it on the bottom. And this one, I'm gonna do the same thing. Put a little bit of white hair on top of the hook shank, so it's not half and half. Make a platform right there. I'm going to put just a hair of black in there. Maybe a quarter of what the hair I used on the last one. Set that right on top. Take some olive. That on the top, and now hold the sides and pull straight down on it so it flares everything up. Bring that back. Now I'm gonna compress all this with hair packer. Make a nice little collar in there. Tie it off. Little head cement. Now I'll do the bottom again. On this segment, I don't need the tip, so I'm gonna cut those off. Put that right in. I get 50%. And roll it over. Tighten it down. I got a nice little shelf right there for the next color. Should be the cream again. Get a couple of pieces of black. Cut the tips and butts even. Put it right on the top. Blur that out. Get the last piece of olive. Put that right there. Boil that up. See if you can find the eye. There it is. Take a couple of wraps and then compress that in. Make a few turns lightly. Don't pull down too hard or you'll break your thread. And fill that air gap in the hook eye. Take a couple of half inches. There's the tying part. Start trimming. And I want to get a bait fish head. So I'm going to rough cut it with my scissors. I don't want to cut too much of the tips off the back though. I'm just going to basically give it a round cut. I like to do this just for, that way I don't cut too much off the first time. A razor blade makes it sharper, but I want to get a nice shape first. And then I'm worried about the gape first, so trim that out. It'll give a little bit, so you get. Now, I'll get my razor blade. Follow the contours. Leave a little of the tips in there. Okay, it's starting to look like a fish head. Round it off a little bit. You gotta be careful around that hook eye. You get that tension off that thread, all that hair will fall off on your table. Okay. That's a pretty nice looking head. Now I'll put some these big eyes. They're stick-on eyes, but I like to cut a hole and put goop in there to hold them. That in, kind of push it into the deer hair, so it'll hold on to more segments you got of it, the better the glue will adhere to it. I don't mind putting new eyes in if I get 5 or 6 tuna on these things. They usually come off really easy. Gotta get them pretty even so they don't look cross-eyed. And there's a bait fish. You can comb this out a little bit and get the wild and woolies out of there. Got a couple of wild ones there. There's a completed bait fish fly.